With an impending Cold War around the corner, China keeps on losing allies. Now another Asian country, Malaysia, seems to be weaning away from Beijing. With Prime Minister Mohyuddin Yassin at the helm of affairs in Kuala Lumpur, Malaysia has been giving frequent blows to China. In a fresh setback to China, Malaysia has rejected China's illegal 9-line theory, whereby China encircles 90% of South China Sea waters as a part of its own territory. With the increasing confrontations and diplomatic tussles in the South China Sea, Malaysia is the latest country to reject China's claims. China claims that Malaysia has no right to establish a continental shelf of its own in the northern parts of the strategic waterways. In response to China's outrageous claims, the Mohyuddin government has invoked the UN Convention on the Law of the Sea, or the UN Clause. In fact, the Malaysian mission has written a strongly worded note verbal dated July 29 to the UN Secretary General Antonio Guterres, stating that Kuala Lumpur rejects China's claims to historic rights or other sovereign rights or jurisdiction with respect to the maritime areas of the South China Sea encompassed by the relevant part of the 9-line. The note verbal expressed that China's claims in the disputed waterways are contrary to the UN clause and added, "The government of Malaysia considers that the People's Republic of China's claim to the maritime features in the South China Sea has no basis under international law." China and Malaysia have been submitting note verbals to the UN regarding the strategic waterways. But till now, Kuala Lumpur's utterances were more or less concerned with its own right to seek the establishment of a continental shelf. The note verbals submitted last week impinged on China's illegal claims in the South China Sea. RAND senior defense analyst Derek Grossman said, "Malaysia's latest statement is surprising on the heels of Pompeo's shift in South China Sea policy because Mahathir had refused to choose sides, US or China. But then again, Malaysia has a new leader now. There's a clear pivot against China in Mohyuddin's Malaysia. This is at odds with the pro-China policies of former Malaysian Prime Minister Najib Razak, who was recently sentenced to imprisonment for a term of 12 years after getting convicted on multiple charges. Razak had taken the Chinese bait during his 9-year-long stint as Malaysia's Prime Minister. He had courted Chinese investments and promoted a peaceful solution to the South China Sea disputes with Beijing. Razak's pro-China attitude had become a major political issue within the Southeast Asian country, and he was even accused of selling off Malaysia to Beijing. Razak's successor Mahathir bin Mohamad, the previous Prime Minister of Malaysia, had actually won the May 2018 elections by raking up the China issue. As such, the Mahathir regime was supposed to counter the growing Chinese influence by replacing a pro-China Razak. But the volatile nonagenarian ultimately succumbed to Chinese influence on issues like Huawei and Chinese belligerence in the South China Sea. Last year, Mahathir had even gone to the extent of suggesting that Southeast Asian countries should work with Beijing. He had said, "We are not really strong enough to tell the Chinese, no, you should not do this kind of thing. It is the international law," or whatever, at a Council on Foreign Relations event in the United States of America. Moreover, Mahathir had also put his weight behind the Chinese telecom giant Huawei, and his government had also criticized the United States over the Huawei controversy. China was able to exercise considerable influence in Malaysia first with Najib Razak and then with Mahathir. But things are changing quickly with Mohyuddin at the helm of affairs. Even before coming at the helm of affairs, Mohyuddin had acted tough on China. Last year, 600 Chinese nationals were arrested in Malaysia over a foreign exchange scam, and Mohyuddin, then Malaysia's home minister, had advised China to put a leash on its own citizens. After coming to power, Mohyuddin government first revoked 5G contracts for 5 companies, which in turn affects Huawei, and now it has come down heavily on Beijing over the South China Sea dispute. The era of pro-China policies in Malaysia is over, and Kuala Lumpur is now going back to its anti-China roots.